pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome to Summer Cougars. Today is Wednesday, June 6th. Welcome to SCTV News. I'm Caleb Kaiser.
And I'm Grace Richter. Seniors, congratulations on your big day. Graduation practice is mandatory and it begins at 9:30. Afterwards, you need to be in the gym with your cap and gown no later than 4 p.m.
For everyone else, the 2018-2019 school year begins on August 9th. Schedules will be sent out by email the day before.
For those students enrolled in summer school, it begins this Monday and runs through June 29th. Don't miss the first day.
Steel Canyon has high standards for student conduct, but are there too many rules, and which ones are the most unpopular with students? Grace and I, along with Daniel Stevenson, has this special report on student conduct at Steel. Rules. Nobody likes them. From cell phones, to visiting your car, to even where you can sit at lunch. It seems like many rules at this school are designed to restrict students' freedoms. Many students believe that certain rules here are unfair.
I mean, if I get dressed, I take my time to get dressed to come to school, and then they dress code me, like, I felt comfortable and I felt confident, and basically we want to feel confident at school, so I'm going to come show up confident to school, and if they dress code me, it's like, now I'm mad, and now I don't even want to do work, so.
Because if I forget my money in my car, then I can't go back to the parking lot and get it, because if I do, then I could get yelled at, and it's just not fair.
I think the school dress code is mainly pointed at the girls, because some girls need to put on some clothes.
A recent poll taken here at Steel Canyon showed the two most disliked rules in the student conduct: dress code and tardy policy.
Well, if you get the tardiness, you pretty much just get lunch detention a lot, and it affects my ability to really do stuff, because at lunch, I go in the library and I start doing my homework, and it takes away time from you. You can't really do anything while you're in lunch detention. So basically what it does, if you're tardy for a number of times, you get lunch detention. And if you don't show up, you get Saturday school. I believe that there should be more leniency, because, you know, there are people with families that probably need help them before they go to class or whatever, which I actually had to do myself when I was a freshman, because, you know, I used to own a ranch and stuff like that, and I had to, feed the farm animals before I left, so it usually made me late as a freshman.
It targets girls. Like, most of the rules are focused on our bodies and how we're a distraction to guys in class, and that if we just show our shoulders or show our legs, that they're not going to be able to focus on their work. I don't think that shoulders and like your back and your stomach are that much of a distraction, and especially when we live in San Diego where it's really hot, we should be able to wear clothes like that.
I feel like they need to be more lenient when it comes to being tardy, since there's only one way in and out of the school. It makes it like super hard for people to get here on time, especially because, like, for me, I don't even live that far away from the school, but in order to make it here at 7:30, I would have to leave the house at like 6:40 to get here on time. And that's like, it's good to like start early, I think, but when you have to be at school or like in the car driving towards school like an hour before school even starts, even though you live like 10 minutes or like 5 minutes away from the school, I think it's like almost ridiculous.
I feel like they should lower down the strictness, because I want to wear a tank top, but I can't. And other girls too, and other boys too.
School rules are disliked by many students on campus, but they have to be there for a reason. Administration says that all rules on the campus have a purpose.
Dress code is there primarily so that we deliver a safe message to our students and to our parents in our community. Dress code is also there because our purpose here on campus is to focus on academics and not necessarily what our style or what we can show or not show.
Many staff members on this campus agree with administration. Many teachers feel being tardy is a disruption to class.
It's frustrating for a few reasons. One is obviously that the teacher was on time. So that becomes frustrating that we feel like we can get there, and when that's not reciprocated back from somebody else, that's frustrating. But the bigger issue is we like to teach bell to bell, and so as soon as that bell rings, we want to get right into our day, whether that's going over the objective or getting into the first activity. So A, that student's missing that experience, but also when that student walks in, it's distracting for everyone else in the room. So it's not only taking away from that one student, but it's taking away from the rest of them.
So whether you absolutely despise them or agree with them entirely, school rules are a necessity to keep things running smoothly at Steel Canyon. For SCTV News, I'm Caleb Kaiser.
Today ends the first full year of SCTV News. It is also the last broadcast for this group of broadcasting students.
Everyone involved wants to thank all the teachers who show the broadcast every day and all the students who watch with interest.
We also want to say a special goodbye to our only senior student, Michael Anderson. Congrats on your graduation. Any final thoughts?
Go subscribe to my YouTube at Michael Anders.
That's all the news we have for you today. Have a great summer. Rah, rah, Cougars.
Cougar pride.
Get some!
Add me on Snap.
Here it is, a groove slightly transformed, just a bit of a break from a